Hello, very good morning, children. Today we are going to discuss about a new topic in economics, people as a resource. That is second chapter in economics, people as a resource. As I think you have already studied this almost a similar content in 8th standard, that is human resources. So you know very well that something related to human beings. Can we call ourselves as a resource, children? Can we call ourselves people as a resource? Can we call? See, it is said that each and every people or a person is having, each and every person are having certain skills. Some will be taking it outside, some may not. Yes, because of certain circumstances, some certain times we won't be able to take our skill outside. Yes, so this chapter also begins with such a story. That what I said, the case of two children, that is, even though both are living in a same village, but the circumstances or the situations that they are facing through their life is different. That is, the story of Sekal, the story of Sekal and Vilas. Story of Sekal and Vilas. Two children. Yes. And let me begin. Anyway, we are going to deal with how we ourselves can contribute towards the development of the country. What we need to bring out our skill. Yes, people as a resource. We as a resource. We as a resource. See, three types of resources you have studied in 8th standard, I believe. That is, one is natural resource, that is the resources which can be taken from the nature directly. Second is human made resource, that is the taken raw materials from the nature are being converted into another form with the help of technology, that is called as human made resources. And the third one is human resource, that is, see, to take the raw materials from the nature and to modify that particular resource into another form, we need what? That person need what? Skill. Ability. That person should have certain ability to tap that resources. To utilize that resources. Isn't it? That is called as human resource. So what we need to bring out our skill. That is what we are going to study in this chapter. So, we begin the story, the chapter, by saying the story of two friends, that was Sekal and Vilas. Though they are living in the same village, Sekal, he's a hard-working student. He's a hard-working child, studies well, but a certain financial problems were there. But still, by saying his hard work, lots of problems were being facing by his family members. But still, as he works hard, and his father every time have a dream that he need to bring his child into high heights. Understood? So that dream plus the hard working of that child, because of this problem, because of this itself, this child, Sekal, works hard and he got a good marks in 10th standard, further in 12th standard, and later they took educational loan and he studied, or he went for a professional course, and later he got a good job in a company, later he got promotion. This is the life of what? Sekal. But see, the case of Vilas entirely different. He was going on facing lots of problems. Yes, very younger age itself, father had some small job. He used to get very less wages, and because of certain health problems, he later died. And mother was forced to go outside for work, and still she also was not able to earn much. She was forced to work outside, go outside for taking care of her children. Later, mother also had certain health problems, and at last, Vilas was forced to go outside to take care of his family. Understood? And he was not able to continue his studies. So sad. Understood? So what happens is he was forced to drop his studies. Take care of his family, because in front of this boy, no other option was there, because he was the only earning member to take care of his family there. So that is what I say. Even though certain times, though we have the skill, but certain times we won't be able to bring it outside. Understood? So this is the case. So likewise, see children, if in your class there are 40 children, can we say that all these children are coming from same background? Can we say that all these children are coming from same background? No. Each will be facing certain problems. They are coming from different backgrounds. Different social background, different cultural background, religious background, financial background. Understood? So that will be reflected in their character also, in their lifestyle also. Is it clear? So, what happens is, so here what we are discussing is, people as a resource. How, what we need to bring out our skill outside. See children, what we need. What we need. See, anyway, in the last chapter you have studied that. In the last chapter what we have studied is the story of village Palampur. We have studied that it was an imaginary village where the people of this particular village is trying hard to bring out that particular village into the forefront, providing all the types of facilities. Isn't it? They are not having all the facilities like that of a town, but still the people were working hard. They were engaged in not only in the farm activities, but also in certain non-farm activities also. Yes. So, in the case here, the people as a resource, it's our duty to take India to the level of economic development. So, what we need to do? What we need to do? Neither plants nor animals can play our role, isn't it? We ourselves have to. So, how to bring out our skill? Yes, we have certain skill. We need to utilize the natural resource properly. We need to utilize or we need to contribute in the form of different inventions, discoveries. Then only our country, India, can reach the level of economic development. So, how we need to? In this case, Sakal was a hard-working student, so opportunities were there in front of him. But this boy, Vinas, was forced to. What happened? So he is going into war again and again, problems as he was not able to continue his studies. So to bring out our skill from this story, the story of these two boys itself, it is very clear that in order to bring out development, what we need, the two important factors, see when we take the case of Japan or any other developed countries, can we say that all these countries are developed countries are having rich resources? No, they don't have. Then how they reached at the level of development, or how these countries have been declared as a developed country? See children, they are investing their money in, mainly in the people, in the Japan and many of the developed countries are investing their money in the, on the people, on their education and health. Education and health. But what about the case of India? Still now India is considered or declared as a developing or being known as a developing country. Set as a developing country. Developing means we are not developed. We still are facing many problems. What are the major problems that we are facing? Even though India is rich in natural resources. India is rich in natural resources. Isn't it? But because of the high population, large number of population, these resources are not enough to satisfy the needs of the human beings. Understood? We are not able to invest the whole of the money on their education and health. See the condition. Can we say that the Vilas family was able to invest their money on Vilas for his education? No. Circumstances is different. Backgrounds are different. So what we need to understand is, to bring out our skill outside, to bring out, okay children, I need to teach properly, yes, or assume that when I was a child, I need to become, or my wish, my goal was to become a teacher, assume that, yes. So when I was a small child, we know that they are war dependent category. Children up to 15 years, they need to depend upon their family, their parents, their elders, their society, their teachers. Because these are the sources from where they are getting knowledge. And it is the response. responsibility of the elders to provide what? To provide what? Education for the younger children. Yes. So to become or to reach at my goal as a teacher, first of all, we need what? We need the two important factors that we need to bring out our skill or to make ourselves as a resource. Make ourselves as a resource is what? One important factor is education. One important factor is education. So they provided me education. Okay, I continued my studies. Yes, my training, everything is over. It's only because of them, the society, my teachers, my parents, the elders, isn't it? They helped me to have a proper education. Then later I got a good job. Right? Opportunities we need. Yes? And to study properly also, we need what? I need a, suppose, see children, if I am not able to take class as I am having severe headache, will you get satisfaction? No. Will I get satisfaction? No. My class will be effective only when I have what? Proper health. And it's my responsibility to maintain a proper health. When I was a child, it's the responsibility of the parents, of the family members. When I become old, yes, then it's my responsibility to take care of my health. Is it clear, children? So, education and health is the two are the two important factors which we need to maintain or to bring out our skill resource and to change ourselves as a resource. If we are able to maintain a proper health, if we are having more and more education, definitely we will be able to bring out our skill and we will be able to contribute our productivity in any activities. In any activities means usually people are engaged in primary, secondary and tertiary activity. Yes, if I get more and more education. See children, it's only because of this. Because it's the responsibility of the government also to take India to the level of economic development. For that, the people should contribute. Understood? People, illiteracy level should be come at the, or we should have, or we need to declare our country as a fully literate country. We didn't reach that level, but still we are trying hard. And it's as a part of this, we know that the government of India have implemented Right to Education Act. Right to Education Act. And it's as a part of this Right to Education Act. It's as a part of this Right to Education Act, government have implemented what? Free and compulsory education for the children in between 6 to 14 years. That is, at least they will be able to complete or to have a minimum qualification of 10th standard. So the government can ensure proper literacy. How many literate people are there? Yes, how many literate people are there? If not, yes, they will be able to take certain measures. Why? What is the gross enrollment ratio? How many people? Even in northeastern states, we can see children. We can see, as we are living in Kerala, we are not experiencing that problems because Kerala is being considered as a 100% literate state in India. Understood. But this is not the case in other states of our country. Even people are there, children are there who are not having. See, what is the definition of literacy? Literate. Who can be called as a literate person? A person who is aged 7 or above, who is able to read, write and understand a language, can be called as a literate person. So child laborism can be found in many northeastern states. So government, see, as a part of this, government is providing free and compulsory education for the children up to 14 years. You might have heard free, how the government is providing at a free cost, free education, free uniform, free books, isn't it? A free course they are providing, and you might have heard of midday meal programs. Government is providing, isn't it, for these children to ensure a complete 100% literacy in our country. If we will get proper education, definitely we will be able to change our attitude, the economy. We will be able to bring up our economy to the forefront. Yes, health also is important. Health also is important. You might have heard, a sound body only in a sound mind in a sound body, a sound mind only in a will be there only in a sound body. So first of all, we need to have a healthy body. Yes, then only we will be able to bring out our skill. Is it clear? So how to maintain our health? Okay, education we can, it's a responsibility of the parents, family members, society, etc. And as a part of this, government also is playing their own role. And how to maintain the health? Okay, we are saying that in order to maintain our proper health, a person need a minimum calorie. Person need a minimum calorie. What do you mean by calorie? Calorie means what? Yes, minimum nutritional food needed for a person to survive. And what is the minimum nutritional food needed for a person? A person who is living in urban area need 2100 calorie, and a person living in rural area need 2000 calorie. Why rural people need more calorie? Why rural people need more calorie? Because they are physical laborers. They are working with their body. Right? So they need more calorie. But is it possible for us now to predict, okay, I have this much calorie today. Can we say like that? Can we assess our calorie content? How much calorie we had in today? No, it's too difficult. Understood. So it will be better to assess the health condition through an instrument called what we call body mass index. What we call body mass index. So how to calculate body mass index is weight in kilogram divided by height in meter square. Height in meter square. If the body mass is less than 18.5, that child or that person will be underweight. If it is more than 25, it will be overweight. Very easy to calculate. So after the class, you also can calculate your body mass index and you can assess whether you have a proper health or not. Accordingly, you can adjust. If you are more than 25, you can follow a diet. If you are underweight, if it is below 18.5, you can have more nutritional food. Understood? So these are the two important factors. See, children, country need for the development. Country always need what? Educated and healthy people. Educated and healthy people. Literate and healthy people are always what? An asset to the country. They are an asset at the same time. Unhealthy people and illiterate people are always a liability. So, we need to bring out our skill outside through education and through maintaining our health. Then only we will be able to engage in either in primary or secondary or tertiary, so that we will be able to contribute more according to our skill and contribute towards the GDP or national income. Thereby, our country can achieve economic development. It's a very simple chapter, a small concept only. What is human resources and how to bring out our skill. And I think this topic is very clear for you. Thank you.